stop by with the in Fredonia, New York. stop by in Fredonia, New York. In Fredonia, New York. In Fredonia, New York. Fredonia, New York. In Fredonia, New York. In Fredonia, New York. stop by for the in Fredonia, New York.
I was drunk, I was gone, that don't make it right, but promise there were no fear ones involved. She said, but it's all we are, and I say, it wasn't religious for sure. She said, save your apologies, baby, I just gotta know.
Couple stops. So that's most likely going to be Plattsburgh's first shot on net after Fredonia gains 7.
Fredonia playing a very offensive game recently. As in the current.
Yeah.
The words escape me.
Face off. Denoyer wins that one for Plattsburgh, but it winds up in their own zone. Tips it back. Wilbur tries to intercept, but it's tipped off Valentine's stick up into the Plattsburgh bench. Colin Valentine, last weekend scoring his first 2 collegiate goals. Another great showing last night. Look at a couple good opportunities. Showing that same. Max Blitz goes for a tumble, and the puck goes beyond him off a pass from the neutral zone, but Fredonia will recover momentarily as its pass to Jelinski is intercepted, but they recover again. Here's Leonard, shoots it high up to the glass, into the corner. Jelinski tries to catch that, but the Plattsburgh Cardinals will come away with it. It's a shot on net, sticked wide by Anton Rosen. This one circles way around out of the zone. Jamie Young snaps that pass away. He's going to pull up looking for a friend. Shoots it in on net instead, and it's gloved by the netminder, Lawson Fenton. And we have another whistle here.
Despite Fredonia's aggressive style, Lawson Fenton seems to be blocking quite a good number of the shots quite effectively.
Yes. Fredonia, the Fredonia prone to put the shot on the net, as any good hockey team should, but it's usually an issue of quality when it comes to performance on the night. Now off the draw, Tracy shoots it in from the circle. A good shot. That one from the far corner is blocked. It'll bounce up out of play. So last night, the puck goes out of play just like there, and it's on that top of that DFT communication sign. It doesn't come back to the ice, but instead another puck stuck up there does come down. That was an enjoyable moment for the night. Fredonia will win that draw. Plattsburgh will clear high once again into the rafters. So you could say they're shooting for the stars. But I always wondered, if they shoot it up into the rafters and it just sails through one of the beams, is that still in play? Discuss. For those at home.
I'd like to think it would be.
Yeah, it's not interfered with. It's continuous momentum.
That would be interesting.
The inside corner, good staple hit right there. Fredonia tries to fight this one center, but Plattsburgh doing a good job of keeping it on the outside.
Four Uni's going to pick it up on eight for Plattsburgh.
Whoa, look out!
Ooh, and it went stands.
Yep.
Four Uni lost it.
They throw it back. That's cute.
That's amazing. That was a good shot.
I always wondered
sportsmanship.
I always wondered. They have the nets on the ice, like the traditional down at the ends. It's more no one's sitting. I just wondered about that.
That is really bizarre. Mainly because I don't think they expect, because mostly the shots on net would be the ones that would go up.
Yes. You'd be losing a lot of pucks, I suppose, going out.
Belafonte going in.
Yes, Fredonia. Collects in their own zone. Young to Morgan. Morgan sprints up the ice, comes in onside, just behind Schaus. Schaus will shoot it on net. Tyler Reiter tries to fight that one through.
Logan Scott, he's bringing it down to Fredonia's side.
A shot in on Rosen. And a whistle. Borderline trip there, if you noticed it coming down the ice. Fredonia also prone to make mistakes. They certainly... The eyeball test, certainly, they take a lot of penalties.
Plattsburgh Cardinals are giving them a good show, though.
Mm-hmm. Around behind the Fredonia net. Dodging a hit. There was Spugnardi. Plattsburgh maintains possession in the zone. Failed clear. Shot in, Rosen middle. Sticks it wide. We're 20 on the far boards. Schultz with Middleton.
Logan's
for
picking
Logan.
Up Fredonia side.
Freeman. Logan picks it up, shoots it in, but it's blocked up wide. Here come the Blue Devils. Josh Biasulo across the blue line. A shot, and it's tipped up and high and out of play.
That is something I'm noticing, though. Fredonia plays quite aggressively, which could go to their advantage tonight.
Yes. Certainly. If the game gets rolling, they certainly like to start throwing their bodies around.
Plattsburgh playing a bit more passively, but that could also lead to good plays by them.
Yes. Take a pause here where the ref inspects the Fredonia bench. Ice problems in front of the Plattsburgh bench. The ref tending to. It's a rough patch there as they pack that in with snow. Suppose it gives me a moment. Yes, Fredonia. Fredonia, it's... They take a couple different paths, but they tend to stick to them. If the game gets going, they'll start throwing the body around. Now, that can go two ways. That can be really good for them, and that can work for their possession. Or they start to take bad penalties.
Yep, and they could also be slipping up more often due to the aggressiveness.
Yep.
It leaves little room for contemplation on shots.
Speaking of shots, 10-4 in favor of Fredonia. Looking at 8:34 left in this first period. No goals so far as Biasulo lines up to take the faceoff draw against Denoye. Fredonia has to follow this one down into their own zone.
Nairn went in for that steal there.
Behind the Plattsburgh net. Momentary panic is Lawson, Fenton got a little loss there, but here's Denoye with McCartney. Denoye pulls up.
Sends it off to Nair. It's going down.
Corner. Here's a chance, and there's a goal. McCartney. Oh, McCartney with an open net just to Anton Rosen's right. And a shot from the corner. A nice give and go.
I think that's where we're seeing Plattsburgh's calm, calculated approach seem to be paying off.
With exactly 8 minutes. As I check my phone.
Now let's see if Fredonia can match that.
Yes, that's certainly another diverging path point for Fredonia's game. A little more traditional in the game of hockey, but Fredonia is a prime example of it. They can step up, or they wind up kind of losing their cool here a little bit as we bunch up in the front of the net. Spagnardi goes to the ice. He gets turned around, and that's an icing.
That first goal has definitely done something to their morale.
As we're now in the face-off circle down back in front of Fenton. Cardinals win the draw, but Fredonia comes away with it. Blitz sends it in on net. Through a screen. Fenton's forced to make a save. Right on the door there is a check.
Lawson's got it down to Fredonia's side.
Lawson, a one-on-one shot. Anton Rosen makes that stop. Anton Rosen's previous two games of action were both wins, so he's had a perfect record. With a 9.14 save percentage, that's, in layman's terms, doing very well. Here's Polachuk in the corner. Tracy picks that up as he tries to shoot it. It's blocked down. Manley winds up. Here's Logan coming away with it. Tipped up. Back to the Plattsburgh zone.
Middleton going in for the contest.
Deep Tracy from behind the net tries to sneak around. He's found out and thwarted by Fournier. Freeman there shoots it in on net. Good opportunity as Tracy's down on the ice. A collision at the net mouth. Here's Logan, temporarily losing track of it, but he manages to gain possession. Contested by Spagnardi circling behind Anton Rosen in the Fredonia zone. Passes to Middleton at the blue line. A bounce up, a tip in, and Plattsburgh is now leading 2-0.
6 minutes and 14 seconds left.
Fredonia caught looking the wrong way at the wrong time. And a neat little tip that I was quick enough to notice. Those tips happen very quick. And you got the you got our friend Paul. Wave hello, Paul.
Middleton was going to get that, but it went over to Fredonia's side.
Our 27 for Plattsburgh. Rich McCartney 15-46. Again with the goal. So that's a 2-goal night already for McCartney. You know what they say in the business, hat trick watch. Solid hit. Schultz gets stuck down on the ice for a few seconds. Fredonia pids the puck into their corner. Stollard passes up the ice. Logan in the corner. Fredonia passed. Shoots it up ice. It's bounced off his skate, sent back the other way, out of play behind the Fredonia zone. Now we'll have a neutral zone face-off just at the Fredonia bench. And Fredonia will win the draw. Young at the blue line. Tried to keep it in, but Plattsburgh comes away with it. Stollard shoots it in. It's wide off the top of the stick of Anton Rosen. Valenti shoots it in, a tip, but Morgan's able to control as he goes behind the Fredonia net. Cool things down. Jamie Young comes up the ice with it. A simple dump in as he holds off for a change. Mike Freeman completes the dump. And now Fredonia completes that line change as Plattsburgh comes up the ice with it. Here's Lawson going behind the Fredonia zone there with Leninger. 48 and Logan circling behind the net. Wilbur tries to get in there and put a stop to things, but Fournier is going to get that pass. It's shot, it's wide. Logan doesn't get to it in time. Checked to the ice there is Corey Valentine. Fredonia gets the puck ahead of the zone. A shot, it's wide to the left. Big hit there again on the doors, emphasized by those articulated joints. It's pretty funny how both big hits have come in that exact spot. Fredonia looking like they're trying to simplify things here a little bit, which is a good strategy, but that limits your options when entering the zone.
Plattsburgh has brought up their shots. Now it's 11 Fredonia, 9 Plattsburgh.
Fredonia being kept for the most part to the outside of the zone on entry when they get into the attacking zone. So Mike Leonard trying to sneak behind his net. He's going to give it away to Fournier. Plattsburgh has the puck. Tenoyer. McCartney to Middleton. Middleton into the corner. Is going to race Jelinski behind the net. Tries to drop it off. A shot off the pads of Rosen. A second shot from Middleton. A delayed penalty here as Fenton will head to the bench.
See if Plattsburgh can continue this momentum they're on, or Fredonia will stop them in their tracks.
I'm not sure why Fenton was heading to the bench. We're trying to figure out. There we are. Wilbur's heading to the penalty box. Well, now we know exactly why. So Fredonia will face their first penalty kill of the night. Wilbur goes 2 minutes for hooking. A shot in, it's wide. It's on the ice. Here's Fournier at the bottom of the blue line. Shot in from number 6, Evan Lindquist. Lindquist back to Fournier.
Fournier misses the shot.
Tracy gets in there to put a stop to things, and he's going to force a clear. Good at move by Victor Tracy to just get in there, get the stick on the ice, and stop the play there from happening. Tap forward for Stollard of Plattsburgh. Fournier
loses it.
Loses an edge, and he goes to the ice. Fredonia going down another man here. That's going to be counted as a trip. The sixth man on for Plattsburgh. In advance of this penalty, call.
Going it is.
Yep.
So far, Plattsburgh 2 goals. Fredonia 2 penalties.
Oh boy. Seems I've predicted the future. I mentioned that Fredonia tends to try to push the envelope, and they kind of get a little sloppy on when it comes to giving up penalties. So here is...
They throw as many bodies at the puck as they can.
Stop that puck at all costs. Here's Schaus at the faceoff circle. Valenti.
Valenti.
Valenti. With Lawson on the wings.
Valenti's looking for that shot.
Switches out with Lawson.
Lawson, back to Valenti. Back to Lawson.
The corner, Stollard. At the circle to Lawson. Looking for a shot. Fredonia getting in the way of things so far. Valenti.
Fredonia seemingly
to Egan, yes.
Fredonia seemingly looking more conservative.
Yep, they're bunching up. Here's Rosen, makes a stop. Plattsburgh keeps it in. Denoyer. Lawson. Valenti. Stollard.
Plattsburgh keeps circling, looking for that shot.
A lot of circling going on. Here's a shot from a bad angle. The stick breaks, and Fredonia's going to be able to come away with it. Bobby Polacek goes up the ice trying to make something of it. He scores! A shorthanded goal for Polacek. He goes end-to-end, and it's now 2-1.
Fredonia hopefully making their comeback with this one.
Ah, what a move. A broken stick.
And then a goal.
A broken stick and a goal. In the Fredonia zone, they get a chance at a break, and Polacek, he's all throughout yesterday's game, he was trying to go up ice, make something happen. He's just trying to be the one-man show, but in this case, it works.
Plattsburgh really thought that they could have had that momentum from the beginning of the game, shoot all the way through, but only showing them otherwise.
Polacek unassisted it short with a shorthanded goal. That's going to bring at least one man down back onto the ice. 40 seconds left on the second penalty Fredonia took in that period of play. Here's Denoyer, or Fournier rather. Passes to Sloan. He tries to race up the ice. He's sealed off by Potter.
30 seconds left in the period.
Hard shot off the board. As Lindquist collects it from the netminder Fenton Lawson. Left off for Fournier. Fredonia tries to go. It's picked up by Polacek. Couple stick bounces, and Rosen has to make a stop with 12.3 to go here. Plattsburgh has completed their comeback on the shot count. It's 13-12, thanks to that two-man advantage. Wilbur comes in for the faceoff draw
with Sloan.
Wilbur will win it. Fredonia, all they got to do is clear at this point, as the period will come to an end. We're behind the Plattsburgh net in the final couple of seconds here. Leninger has the puck as the horn sounds. So, at the end of one, Plattsburgh pushes the advantage early on a couple solid plays. But on the penalty kill, Fredonia gets one back. But we have yet to see the full comeback here, as
frankly, it is still anyone's game.
Yep, certainly. Well, no, we usually know about halfway through the second where this is going. Fredonia, I made the illusion a couple games ago. They're a 50-50 coin flip kind of team. They got one side or the other where they keep things tight and they make good plays, or they're throwing the body around, making a couple mistakes here and there that wind up not really doing too well for them. So, I think Fredonia certainly, this will take this 15-minute break here to reset themselves. It's similar to the game with Potsdam yesterday, where they came out and Potsdam was prone to get two goals in that first period as well. And I think Fredonia got one. So far, a mere replica.
Hopefully they can learn from their mistakes.
Yes, definitely.
Try and do better.
So I think we'll call it there. This is definitely going to be a different tone. Again, I'd just like to say thank you for hopping on with me, Kyle.
No problem.
I would have been doing this alone if it weren't for you.
I apologize for my lack of experience here.
It's more fan than fanatic. Yeah, that's what I said in roundup tone. Speaking of weekend roundup, I might as well plug my own show coming up here tomorrow. Normally weekend roundup happens on a Friday night, but then hockey started. that eats up our start time for roundup. So Harper Horton and I moved the show to Sundays at 7 p.m. Eastern, of course.
Right here on WDVL.
On WDVL, right. Right. So I believe once 7 o'clock rolled around, those listening to WCBF 889 FM joined us here on Hockey Night in Fredonia. So before we step away, I just again introduce ourselves. I'm Jarrett Belschmander with
Kyle Mascara.
Excellent. You're listening to Hockey Night in Fredonia from Steel Hall. A 2-1 lead for Plattsburgh at the end of one.
Plattsburgh having 14 shots, Fredonia 12.
Crazy stuff. All right. Take a step away here. You're listening to 88.9 WCBF FM, 89.5 WDVLF cable injected.
And worldwide at FredoniaRadio.com.
Also, WNYF TV, the YouTube live stream, the FredoniaBlueDevils.com boxcast stream, all kinds of places. Tune in anywhere you want. It's all free real estate. We'll see you at the end of the period, at the end of the break.
Now's the time to ask the reason. Should
kicking it. Fredonia coming at you from Steel Hall here in Fredonia, New York. Jared Boschwinder and Kyle Mascara.
Yep, that's me.
Ah, nice to have you. Thanks. As of last check, nothing has changed. It was the intermission. Currently, Fredonia sitting behind a goal. The Plattsburgh Cardinals come in and get too early on this in this match so far. Fredonia pours seven shots on net to start off the game. But once Plattsburgh got that one shot, it's all it took. They didn't score on that first shot, but they scored certainly soon after.
They kept that momentum rolling through.
Yep.
Plattsburgh seems to be playing it very, very calm, calculated.
Yep.
Fredonia throwing bodies at that puck.
Fredonia is,
It's a risky maneuver, but it can work. I can definitely
see it. It does work. It can work.
Especially if Plattsburgh were playing too passively.
Yeah.
It would definitely work. But Plattsburgh, I mean, it's they're matching them with those blows. Yeah.
Plattsburgh and Potsdam, two of the most difficult matchups for Fredonia across the season schedule. You never get one or the other. They always a 1-2 punch coming at you. So this is always usually a make or break weekend for Fredonia. They lost the game yesterday. This is definitely a weekend they don't want to come out with no points having, because as we talked about in the beginning of the game, Potsdam and Buff State have already leapfrogged them ahead in the standings. A loss tonight would most likely send them probably into the bottom three, but I mean, that's if you're prone to believe in the domino theory.
Yeah.
And certainly a mojo thing can certainly come from that as well. Definitely feel a lot better yourself. A lot better about yourself hitting the ice when you're up there in the standings and you're producing things on a nightly basis. But we still have two periods of play to go, so you certainly can't say that
Fredonia could just pull a 1-2 punch, win it, and completely defy all expectation. And by that I meant going off your piggyback there.
Yes.
When you said that it tends to be a 1-2 punch with Plattsburgh.
Yes. 1-2 punch be the 3-4 punch to the 1-2 punch. Team's taking to the ice now. Initially, Fredonia looking to stay off that penalty kill. That would be the case. Fredonia needs to. It's definitely like you said. There's no wrong in throwing bodies at the puck, but you just can't. You gotta put a little puck.
Yeah.
Our starters remain on opposite sides of the ice. Lawson Fenton in net for the visiting Cardinals, and Anton Rosen in net for Fredonia.
On the Plattsburgh side, sticking with those ones. Pat Egan, 16. Cole Stoller, 20. Noah Batta, 17. Fenton Lawson, 33. Sam Schultz, 5.
There we go. Got Haynes Martin, Polichuk, Young and Tracy out on the ice to start this one off. The starting line's back at it again as the second period begins. And the refs, instead, they decide, over time for chat.
Trying to see how everything's going.
It's interesting to speculate what they might be talking about.
Well, I never know, really. Going back to the conversation of tactics here, I mean, there's a reason people who write books about sports, including hockey, say that it's very similar to war, and the fact that you do need those tactics involved there.
Yes. And tactics in refereeing, there's certainly some thought behind what the ref perceives of the game, where the direction is heading, and how he can correct the course to keep it on keep it relatively sane.
Yep, and you also have to realize that there is going to be some bias there.
Definitely. Off we go. Off the draw, Schultz for the Cardinals. As possession, they go back and forth in their own zone as they try to organize a rush out of the ice. Fredonia collects there at the Plattsburgh bench door. And Fredonia puts one on for attack. Tracy tries to back pass it up towards the net now. Holichuk finds it, they score! It's a puck that lands right in front of the netminder Fenton. And Holichuk's there to slam the stick out of the ice, and it just pops right into the top of the net.
There we go. That's Fredonia coming back after that break.
So definitely, they definitely thought about this. So we are only 29 seconds into this second period. Fredonia ties this one up. All new ball game, etc. Yeah, Holichuk will credit the goal. Assisted by Spugnardi. And Hines. And they're all back out there again, trying to see if they can make squeeze any more out of this great burst of offense at the opening handful of seconds of this period. Losing the stick down there in the corner was Evan Lindquist. Zielinski tied up on the boards there, a couple hits, but Fredonia maintains presence in the attacking zone. Like this one for Wilbur, tries to sneak it through. Here's Wilbur alone, he scores! Wilbur! 5-0 on Floss and Fenton. It's 3-2.
Truly an amazing spectacle. Here's Fredonia, scores 2 goals in a row. I mean, it's unbelievable.
That was great. That's exactly what the doctor ordered. Right on time, Fredonia scores.
As I said, Fredonia, I mean, they've got some bizarre tactics here, but they can pull it off if they try.
They pulled it off. They definitely...
They're really showing their all.
Wilbur credited the goal. Assisted by Jolinski. 1:11 of the second. Wild times, and then the blink of an eye. 2 goals, just about 20 seconds.
I know, you're going to want to keep your eye on that Plattsburgh net.
Fredonia, the ice tilted heavily in their favor to start this game. Puck off the stick of Martin, bounces back into their zone. And Bowie shooting it in. Martin and Schaus on the inside boards. Organize a rush going the other way. Jimmy Morgan collects behind the net. Schaus circles around. Here's a chance. Spugnardi trying to fight it through. Was Tyler Ryder. Now we're gonna get a little intense debate there in the net mouth.
Cool. Plattsburgh is really feeling the hurt on this one.
Plattsburgh definitely on their heels here going, what just happened?
I know. Let's see if Fredonia can keep cool, maintain that momentum all the way through.
Definitely. Fredonia can keep this up. This. Yeah, they'll definitely be well on their way to taking 2 points out of this weekend after last night's loss to Potsdam.
Definitely Plattsburgh's going to be looking for that opening there.
Schwartz there for Logan in neutral ice. The Cardinals go. Here's Bates. A shot. It drifts wide of Rosen behind the net now. The Cardinals shoot this one up. It's loose for Schwartz. Just on top of the circle. Middleton bumps with Gerhardsen. It's dumped into the neutral zone where Bates can collect. Try to move this one forward a little bit. But Fredonia doing a good job of keeping that puck right where it is. Tracy That's a pass. Fredonia possession. A shot in. It drops in front of Fenton. Circling the net. Emma Leonard at neutral ice picks it up, but it's now in the stick of Denoyer, who with some good moves gets an open chance, but it's thwarted, and Fredonia turns it around. Tracy enters the attacking zone, sets up Hines, who crashes the net, but he's tripped up. That comes off its moorings. And it looks like all signs point to this game remaining at 5-5. Denoyer wins the draw, but it was still in the Cardinal zone. As Valenti forced to double back there. As he waits for support moving forward down the ice. Young gets in front of that shot. It deflects up into the glove of Anton Rosen. A great glove save, and the crowd shows their support.
There's some good coordinated plays going on here.
Yep. And as I mentioned, it's Rosen 2-0 so far in the season. Definitely, if there's any rallying point on this game, so you certainly want to help out your friendly neighborhood goaltender. Wilbur just tucks that inside the blue line, so he remains onside. A collision there at the Fredonia door sends the puck all the way in front of Rosen, where Martin collects. It's tipped up. Plenty racing against Lindquist. So we circle the net here. Valentine knocks it down. Morgan at the red line. Going the other way now. Here's the Cardinals trying to fight this one, but it's sent back with no one in particular. And it continues to drift into the Plattsburgh zone. Fayetz goes down to the ice. Completes the pass. Those are not the far end of the red line. The Cardinals dump and change. Just hearing about 5 minutes gone in the second period. Ritter and Eminger having a nice little discussion. Ritter gets knocked down and takes a knee to the head. No call. The knee to the head was coincidental, but it's still
not momentum was maintained.
Not a good thing. Certainly the first play on that could have been open to interpretation. I'd call that a trip if you were holding close enough scrutiny on that play. Now Leninger shoots that as he collects a pass from the boards behind the Fredonia net. But it's blocked and sent all the way down the ice for an icing. So Fredonia comes out flying. But Plattsburgh seems to have wasted no time matching that pace by about the 5 minute mark of the second.
I know, they're really showing their all right now.
Max Blitz sends it for Sean Leonard, who tips it up, tries to give Gerhardt in the puck in the attacking zone, winds up stapled into the corner. You know, we got four men all down low for Plattsburgh. Strong hit on the door to the Fredonia locker rooms. At the red line. Here's Schultz in the inside zone. Gives it away to Martin. He's going to try and battle his way towards center. A shot in. It's wide through the crease. It's tipped high and into the rafters.
I mean, that play right there, that was, I mean, they were just bullying each other around at that point. That was quite the spectacle to behold.
Certainly the second period has made the entertainment factor a whole lot bigger in this game.
Simply riled up both teams as well.
Yep. I was walking to the game. Hold on, put a hold on that story. Here's McCartney. He scores!
this game.
Three goals. Yep. In the hockey realm, we call that the natural hat trick. Three straight goals in one game.
That means Plattsburgh's going to tie that up at 3-3.
Yep. Hopefully, how's that for your entertainment factor? Here's the draw. Lindquist. Unassisted breakaway goal there. Even strength. Tracy's going to turn it the other way. Go 2-on-1, trying to get something going. Plays thwarted. Sentenced to the inside of boards. All right, turn around again. Good block. Good tip-up play. Goes high up. Airmailed into the Plattsburgh zone. A penalty on the play. I believe this is a holding call, if I remember my signals correctly. And Plattsburgh's number 15. Ayrton Valente is taking the seat. So Fredonia, finally, after her now 13-22 in this second period. Excuse me on that call. It's going to be an interference call. Hines blocks that play. Blitz chases this down. 2 minute minor against the Cardinals. Fredonia heads to the power play as they circle behind their net. Morgan go for the first rush. It's chosen to be dumped down. Polacek's tripped up. And now Fredonia will be going to power play, but Polacek, as a player, seems to be a little bit of agony off that trip. That wasn't too fun. I've fallen on the ice before, I can tell you.
Oh, yeah, no, I've definitely seen my fair share of up-close action with the ice there.
Full face time.
It's not fun. And especially in full gear like that, you're going down and you're taking the full weight of that with you.
Yes. So very, very near to a full couple of minutes of 5-on-3 play for Fredonia. Let's see if they can take advantage of this opportunity. It's out on the ice there. Martin and Blitz at the blue line. Martin has it. Shoots it down in the corner for Jimmy Morgan. Tracy passes back to Martin at the circles. Martin shoots it in. It's blocked by number 25 for Plattsburgh. Morgan circles around, shoots it in. It's a block by Fenton. Fredonia sneaking it in again. It's shot high and wide off the top of the glass. Tracy collects off the boards, crests the blue line, shoots it, taps it off for Martin. Martin passes back to Tracy. Martin into Morgan. Goes wide. A shot, your heart's in. A slap shot from Tracy. It's blocked in front. Tracy gives off for Blitz. Blitz a change off. Here's a shot. It's eaten by Fenton.
Both sides there playing very conservatively.
Plenty of shots. Plenty of good shots by Fredonia.
Those are some very good shots. You see Plattsburgh playing there. Trying to go for a real big defense there. Not trying to get that puck away from Fredonia.
Yep. As long as the shots don't get near the net. Whoa, that went very high. Boy, that one hits the far rooftop. Ceiling.
That was a high fly. That's up in the jet stream there.
Yep. Out of that puck with the woman. Ooh, look out. I firmly believe if it weren't for the glass deflection, that's coming right at me.
that was quite scary.
It was head on, one-on-one. Jeez. All right, heads up, folks. Fredonia coming into the zone. One man back onto the ice for the Cardinals. Wide sweeping play. Great momentum. Polacek at the circle. Shot in. It's tipped up into the netting. Play is stopped. 11-08 in the second. 11 seconds. penalty to the Cardinals.
Fredonia trying to keep it purely on Plattsburgh's side. Trying to make sure that Rawson doesn't see any play. Which is good. Trying to give that love to the goalkeeper.
give him as much reprieve as he can get. He's going to have to play this one. He comes out. It's far down into the Fredonia zone. Spogardi collects it. Long pass up to the opposing blue line for trying to find Valentine. Indy far corner. And behind the boards, Denon Eminger for the Cardinals with Logan, but couldn't beat Freeman, as that's now an icing. Side of the ice. As Josh Biasula takes the face-off against Potsdam's Cole Stallard. Another high lob. Martin collects that at the defensive blue line. Jartson tries to stop Stallard's entry into the zone. They'll stall it just enough to gain possession of their own zone. Ryan Dunn passes up your Hartson and Biasula. Try to go 2-on-1 against the defenseman and the netminder. But it's key wide. Biasula in behind the net. Out of the corner, Eminger for the Cardinals. Sloan enters as Egan is very offside. But despite being very offside, he's still puzzled by being offside. Gotta keep your head up on those plays. You gotta be aware where your teammates are. And it looks like we have an injury now.
Oh.
That's never fun.
That's gonna be number 9, Antoine Denoy.
Denoy.
On the Plattsburgh Cardinals side.
Ooh.
That's never good.
Coming off of a bad limp.
Ooh,
that's not good.
That's never good losing a teammate.
It's not going to be fun. Hope he's all. Wish him the best. There we go. Ryder. At the blue line off the draw. Schultz. Bates and Schultz as well for Potsdam. Middleton comes away with it. Sloan circles up at the inside of the boards. As we go back the other way with Fredonia. Jimmy Morgan's going to find that puck loose. Tries to circle behind the net. Stops up, gets that for Ryder. Blocked off by Valenti. And Sloan. Sloan now follows that down to the neutral zone where Schultz baits. Tied up to Spogardi, Polichuk, and Todd Schaus. Todd Schaus goes in with Morgan. It's a circle. Oh, it's just off the side of the net. Now at the far boards, Schultz for the Cardinals in their own zone. Freeman picks it up at the blue line. It's shot, but it's blocked by the stick of Bates on his way to the bench. Spogardi tips that in before he's hit, stapled to the boards by Lawson. It swings down the other way. Here's Jacob Hines and Sam Wilbur trying to fight this one into the center ice. Lawson Fenton's going to reach out and grab this one as right on his doorstep is Brendan Spogardi, the six foot zero defenseman. Very very not the most ideal guy to have leverage on you on the net there.
Absolutely, I know.
On the corner, Jelinski. Tips it ahead of him for Young, who is waiting at the red line. Wilbur guides one to Young. At the red line, a little couple seconds of back and forth. But Fredonia collects. Valentine sends this one in. Looks like it's going to be offside.
And if you saw on that play, Plattsburgh unaware of where his teammates were. That is never a good thing. You get tripped up that way. That was quite the upset there.
Face-off draw there. Stollard. Cole Stollard of Plattsburgh. Comes away with it. Off the draw. Wilbur collects in their own zone. For Fredonia there. Cross ice. A tip-up. Out of play. Where, I believe it was Max. There was a wide-open net there. Behind Fenton for Tommy Martin. But it looks like someone got their stick in front of a shot. Otherwise, that would have been a golden opportunity for Fredonia. An immediate shot in by Fredonia's Ryan Dunn. Let's get out of the cross ice. Piasula stops that one in its tracks and turns around. Tipped up, just clips part of the Raptors, I suppose.
All right, quick,
Raptors, not the Raptors.
two very different things. No, it seemed to fit the NCAA.
One of the banners?
Banner, there.
They saw that the center ice dot, the big Fredonia Blue Devil logo. Tyler Ryder. Plattsburgh's Ross Sloan. They go up the ice. At the far boards. Top of the circle. Fredonia's going to collect it. Go 3-on-2 the other way. To Todd Schaus. In behind the net. Ryder staples that one to the boards momentarily. Ryder and Schaus. A shot in. Seems kind of lose that momentarily in the corner. So now we've got a couple players from each team there kind of pouring the cement on this play. It's stopped in its tracks. It drifts out for Fenton Lawson. Lawson Fenton. Fenton Lawson, Lawson Fenton.
Play. Flips in. The Mark really summing off. Looks like it's going to be Tyler Ritter. All bets and purposes. The first in the line for fist bumps at the bench. Generally a good indicator of who this goal is going to be awarded to. So only a few seconds on that power play and Fredonia capitalizes. Talk about turnaround. And just like that, Fredonia's back on top of things. 4-3. Tyler Ritter. Assisted by Jacob Haynes. At 14-30. The Cardinals going up the ice. 3-on-2 action. The rush going the other way. As they get to the zone, but it's going to be offside. In a game that's become four bodies at the puck for both teams.
Right, it has become very unconventional. As you can see, I'm pretty sure the coaches on both sides are. Fredonia's probably relieved. Plattsburgh frustrated.
Definitely.
You know, as the dulcet tones of Margaritaville play in the background, you can tell where this game is going.
At the draw at the Plattsburgh bench. The Cardinals will come away with it and shoot it in on that. It's stapled into the inside corner for the Fredonia zone. And a centering attempt foiled, and Fredonia comes away with the Polichuk. Haynes and Tracy go up ice. A shot from Tracy is sealed off by Lawson Fenton. Fredonia circles around. Here's Polichuk at the blue line. Feeds for Schaus, trying to trickle it in once again. It jumps out to the corner boards. And the Cardinals collect it. Here comes McCartney. Up for Sloan. They'll run around there. Jimmy Morgan gets taken to his. For a second there, a shot in Rosen is they took off that down. So interesting connection with the Potsdam and Potts State there. But in addition to coming down to Fredonia, they're also taking swings through Potts State. So as they mentioned there on the PA system, Potsdam currently down 4-0 to Buff State. Here's a 2-on-1 chance. Valentine, a couple lost pucks. That was
truly, just that's the definition of loose. That puck was going wherever it wanted to. No player could stop.
The players were following the puck.
But,
Martin collects at the blue line, shoots it in, looking for the tip of Gerhardsen, but it bounces over his stick just a second earlier than expected. It bounces out to Leonard. And now Dunn shoots this one in, and Fenton will glove that down. Definitely now seeing your assessment earlier where Fenton's definitely electing to eat a lot of those shots rather than let play continue. With 3:11 remaining in this second period, hopefully he didn't blink. Fredonia's currently leading 4-3. As we're going to fight this one in, Fenton again seals this one on the outside.
30 shots to 17. Fredonia definitely being the one to drive this offense so far. And they currently on the scoreboard to show for. Now on the Fredonia blue line, Jelinski gets sealed off on that play, and Cardinals will turn it around from the neutral zone. They like to dump it back into their own zone. A clearing attempt shot. Struggle.